Спасибо, госпожа председатель.
Thank you, Madam President. First of all, I'd like to thank the Polish presidency for organizing this meeting. This meeting is extremely important. Using the example of Iraq, we'll be talking about how coordinated efforts within the UN system give quick and positive results.
The Secretary General, I would like to start by expressing my solidarity with the people and governments where terrorist attacks were recently perpetrated. The list, unfortunately, is long and includes Afghanistan, Belgium, France, Indonesia, Iraq, Libya, and Nigeria. Our prayers are with the victims and the survivors of these heinous attacks. I also call on all member states to redouble their efforts to strengthen international cooperation to address terrorism in a comprehensive manner and bring those responsible to justice. Madam President, thank you for this opportunity to brief the Security Council on the joint visit we conducted with Michelle Konex to Iraq in March this year. This visit was conducted within the framework of common efforts of United Nations Office of Counter-Terrorism and Counter-Terrorism Committee Executive Directorate to facilitate the delivery of counter-terrorism-related technical assistance to member states in accordance with Security Council Resolution 2395. In this resolution, the Council underscored the need for the two UN entities to work closely together. The visit took place at the invitation of the government of Iraq and with the support of the United Nations Assistant Mission for Iraq, for which I am grateful. I am honored to have the opportunity to brief you today alongside my colleagues seated Executive Director Michelle Konex and Jan Kubisch, Special Representative of the Secretary General and Head of the United Nations Assistance Mission for Iraq, as well as Permanent Representative of Iraq Ambassador Alulum. Madam President, Iraq has been affected by and is suffering severely the consequences of terrorism. The military setback of Daesh clearly demonstrates the long-term resolve of the Iraqi authorities in their fight against terrorism. The continued vigilance and determination of the Iraqi government to consolidate the military victory against ISIL through a comprehensive approach focused on both prevention and resilience is of utmost importance. In this regard, I would like to stress the continued commitment of Iraq in addressing the 16 recommendations made by the Counter-Terrorism Committee of the Security Council on advancing Iraq's efforts on implementing key counter-terrorism priorities. Madam President, during our joint mission with CITED to Iraq, we were able to have high-level consultations with a number of ministers and senior officials. In order to understand better the realities on the ground, we visited Fallujah to discuss what could be additionally done from the UN side to support the local population. All our interlocutors stressed Iraq's continued commitment to fighting terrorism as it transitions from a military-focused counter-terrorism approach to a more comprehensive one, which also includes preventive, law enforcement, and criminal justice components. It was the conclusion of our Iraqi interlocutors that national reconciliation and reconstruction, owned and driven by the Iraqi people, are essential to prevent resurgence of violent extremism and terrorism in Iraq. I would like to express my words of appreciation for this kind of approach. During our visit to Fallujah, we had the opportunity to meet with the mayor of the town and a number of survivors. We were witnesses of the large-scale devastation caused by ISIL. I was personally touched by the admirable resilience of the Iraqi people while visiting the reconstruction work in areas surrounded by minefields and booby traps, and youthful faces studying in rehabilitated school premises. Our joint delegation reiterated the United Nations' strong support to Iraq. Based on the priority needs identified during the mission and on the Security Council Resolution 2395, the United Nations Office of Counterterrorism, together with CTAT, proposed five areas in which it could provide technical assistance to Iraq. Firstly, advice for the development of a comprehensive national counterterrorism strategy. Secondly, training on countering the financing of terrorism. Thirdly, prevention of violent extremism through youth skills development and vocational training, including for youth in Fallujah. Fourthly, prevention of violent extremism through strategic communications. And finally, capacity building to prevent and respond to weapons of mass destruction related terrorism. In order to move expeditiously on our fruitful dialogue and in consultations with the government of Iraq and UNAMI, we were able to dispatch a joint UNOCT CTAT scoping mission to Iraq at the beginning of May this year to identify the specific elements of programmatic support under the five above mentioned priorities. The scoping mission held meetings with a range of Iraqi ministries and national agencies, the diplomatic community, as well as the UN country team and the World Bank. Based on the findings of the scoping mission, United Nations Office of Counterterrorism is working now on the development of project concept notes on the priority thematic topics. It's going on about projects that could have a measurable impact on the ground while avoiding duplication with existing initiatives. UNOCT is also planning to deploy a consultant to support Iraq finalize its national counterterrorist strategy. The practical implementation of these projects in consultation with the government of Iraq will start next month. So it took us 3 months from the very beginning up to the beginning of implementation of projects. Madam President, distinguished colleagues, as the Secretary General has often emphasized, United Nations Office of Counterterrorism is committed to deliver on key counterterrorism capacity building priorities of member states. As one UN, in coordinated and coherent manner, and as requested by member states, our joint CTAT UNOCT mission to Iraq in collaboration with UNAMI was a concrete step in that direction. We plan to further build on this approach in other regions of the world. Thank you very much for your attention.